Malty Tapes. Ralphie here. Oh. It's Scotland and it's March and there's been snow this morning, rain this morning, sleet this morning and basically four seasons in one day, but everything cold. Which is the reason for woolly jumpers and little bunnets, keep the rain off. But it's also so happens that it may be shitty for walking about in, but it's great for maturing whiskey in. And one appreciates the finer things after a hard day of lousy weather. Talking of finer things, I had a few fairly mediocre runs from some apparently great distilleries recently, so I really would like to carry on with something magnificent. Here it is. Not a lot left, but when you hear what I have to say, you'll say no bloody wonder. Where's my little magic wand? Refill, just automatically refill again to the brim, No, no luck. This is a signatory bottling, cask strength whiskey. 59.6%, so the angels didn't get much of that one. And it was distilled in 1988 at Mortlach on Speyside. Mortlach is a great distillery. When someone uses the term beefy malt, they're talking about Mortlach. It's emotional, moving whiskey. And with old whiskies, I've actually watched the profile change as the bottle went down and the air got into the bottle and oxidized slightly. I'm going to show you something very interesting. I poured a glass, a similar glass, and added water half an hour ago. Right? Look at the difference between those two whiskies. Distinctly cloudy, clear. When I add water to this one, just poured, it will turn to that over a period of time. That is due to the barley oils in the whiskey, because this is natural, unchill filtered, presented artisan single malt. When I take this back, as you can see, I've got a cover on it, because the angels are not going to get a share out of my room, that's for sure. That's just for the devils like me. Whee! Nose. Super rich, effervescent, syrupy malt, barley, sweet. Caramel, toffee, vanilla, creme brulee, maple, and a real rich beefiness. The taste. Hold it now. Typical old whiskey. It really hangs in there. It coats your mouth. It hangs around. It's not going to fade away. It's going to remain for a while. And it rubs against the cheeks. And it sits at the back of the throat, and you can feel it going down there. Fabulous. Not to be rushed. The taste is sweet, luscious malt with tons of golden barley, Oloroso sherry, superb bitter oak integrated, without the oak dominating in any way, allspice, raisin, touch of absinthe, bitterness, old citrus, and it ends dry and slightly crisp after starting incredibly sweet. Simply superb whiskey. Now, with independent bottlers, get advice before you pay your money. Old whiskies can be expensive. Talk to people. Find out about the reputation of your specialist liquor stores and whiskey shops. look online, check out Malt Maniacs and Whiskey Stuff and the likes of Dr. Whiskey and various other sites. There's a lot of good people online giving good, sound advice. And my advice is 95 out of 100. Fantastic. See you soon.